All right, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to start. We got Lee in the room. She's been working out all day, but she's going to show you how to do it tired. So bring your shoulders up to your ears, press them back, drop them down. Let's start with our hands on your belly. Deep breath in. Bring the shoulders back on the inhale. As you exhale, pull the belly button toward the spine and then zip up the rib cage simultaneously. Let's take that breath again. Deep inhale through your nose. Deep exhale, core connection. Now bring the arms up high and give you a little reach. Reach. So following Lee right here, she's just giving a little stretch. Nice, let's go. For four, three, two, one. She's gonna turn to the side. She's gonna walk her plank down. We're gonna count it down. We're going down. One, two, three, four. Walk it out. One, two, hold right here. Hold four. Four, three, two, one. Walk it back. Now with that core connection, I want you to feel the stretch to the back of the legs. Up, one, two, three, four. Walk it out. Out, two, stick it right here. Now hold what you got right here. We're just going to take your hands wide, maybe drop to your knees. Yeah, we're going to do some push-ups to start it out. Nice and slow. They're going to be five slow, five fast. There it is. So following Lee right here. Knees are on the mat. That is perfect. Or you could always straighten your legs, curl your toes under. Good. Two more slow. It's on a two count for two. Up. One more time. We're taking it low with the bend of the elbows. All the way up. Let's go. Five more. On that beat. There it is. So we're warming up in push-up today. Maybe you're on those knees. You only got two more. On one, hands come back into your shoulders. You're going to walk it back on four. Let's walk back. One, two, three. Bring it back forward into that plank. Two, three, four. Hold. Five, four, three, two, one. Now pull the belly button in. I want you to walk your hands in front of you one at a time. Right hand and then left hand. And then back. It's going forward. So she separated her feet slightly. That's going to give you a little bit more base so we can keep those hips nice and level to the floor. One more time. Let's go forward. Now hold. Stay on your knees. Looks good, Melissa. Now hold right here. We're going to hover the elbows to the floor. We're going to bend the elbows by the rib cage and then straight back up. Looks good, Melissa. Down for two. Everybody taking it nice and slow. The elbow is just skimming the rib cage. You have two more. Down for two. There's your advancement. Legs are straight. One more time. Hold right here. Let's hold this 10-second count right there. That is strong work. We're working deeply into the back of the arms, waist, lats. Good stuff right here. Let's hold for three, two, one. Walk your hands all the way back. Down one, two, three, and four. Stand it all the way up. Roll it up for four, three, two, one. Pick up your one weight in your left hand. Let's start with your left hand today. So she's going to have a chair. That's going to be your stability for a bar when we need it. I want you to bring that right arm high. Take that left hand in your weight, sink it low, down itch, up an itch. Give me a little bicep action right here. Just connecting the bicep. Take the feet out nice and wide for three. Let's go for two. Let me see who just came on one, full range. Hi, Alyssa. There it is, full range. Bend, extend. So wide second position. Now, if your hips are a little tight, you could bring your toes forward. That might be really great if some guys are doing this. Let's go five more for five. You got it for four. How we doing? We got Alyssa, Melissa, and everybody is on here. Let's do two more for two. Now stay low right here. Take the arm out and give me a high heel, low heel. You could always come a little higher than Lee's doing, or you can always hold onto a chair. That's gonna give you a little bit more stability. I want you low in those legs, feeling that rotator. There's your flare. Let's go two more. Two, on one, palms to your screen. It's bend, extend, full range. Now, as you do this move, I want you to really stand it up and then drop it low. So feel that connection of the kneecap coming up into that quadricep. Bend, extend. Let's go. Five more. Looking good. Let's do it for three. For two. Hold right here. Just sweep that arm forward. Pull the belly button in. Give me a little extend. Oh, how's that feel? If that is not for you, give me a bicep curl instead. You only got two more just like that. Hold right here. Palms and ceiling. Pull the belly button in. High heel, low heel. 10 of these. Yeah, and then we're going to bring those heels together. But right now, you're super low. in that wide second. You guys look so good. Hang with me. Let's get it strong and on this Tuesday. Looking good. Let's go. Four. Here it is. For three. Looking good. Two. And one. Now hold. Bring your feet together in a V position. Take your hands to your hip. And let's drop down on four, three, two. Or you've got that chair beside you or arm is in the air. Then we're going down it. Up and inch. So we're going deeper into the front of the legs, the quadricep work, not discounting the deep work in that left bicep, dropping super low. Six more for six. There it is. Five. You guys look good. For four, we're going to combine that move in three. Looks good. In two, as you drop right here, dropping it low, we're going halfway up and then all the way out to the side. It's just keeping the contraction into the bicep, working into that rotator. There it is. It's out. Interesting musically, right? You got it? It's out. One more. Inhale and let's exhale. Bring it here. Drop it one more floor. Bring it back to center. 20 curls. Ooh, yeah. Maybe you hold onto that chair because that's going to be smart. They're going to be able to get lower in the legs. That is your goal. Now, if you want a little more flare, a little more heart rate up, you bring that arm in the air, but don't lose those low legs. Get nice and strong in those quads. That's 10. You got it. Breathe through it. Looking so good today. Nothing like it. Now, get a little lower and feel that bicep curl. How many got length? Final five. We almost there. In four. You got it. Three. Here we go. Two. You know you like to pulse, so drop it one more floor. Pulse it down for 10. Nine, just icing on that cake. Let's go. Breathe through it for five, four, three, two, on one. Stay in the legs, even though she took it out, and I don't blame her. If you need to, do it. Bring that arm right here. Hold onto your chair or arm in the air. Now drop low. Down four, three, stick it right here. Let's go. Overhead presses. So we're combining the movements here. It's going to challenge the legs and the arms simultaneously for a little muscle confusion, which works so beautifully to really treat the body with that respect it needs to change that shape. One more. Hold right here. Super slow. It's in for two as you drop low. Out. Anterior deltoid work. In for two. Out. Let's go three more times. In. How's that shoulder? Maybe on the shoulder work, you drop it to a lighter weight. Listening to your body. Now one more time. Hold. Palms to your face, extend, bend. Light, nice and low to the floor. Let's go three more for three. You guys are killing it for two. Now hold, bring that arm out wide. Now I want you to bring that right arm high, drop low, eight overhead to finish this shoulder. Press, good, press. Yeah, these compound movements are tough on that body, making you smarter as you go. Let's go, four more. There it is for three, looking so good. For two, on one. All right, perfect. Bring it all the way up. Take a little shoulder stretch. All right, so let's bend into that left knee, right arm by the behind the back, and give me a little squeeze. Now, as you squeeze, I want you to watch me from the side. My back is flat. My hips are lower than my shoulders. No roundness. Feeling a lot of work in that nice stretch, that leap through the muscles. We got it. Give me a squeeze, working the back muscles. Let's go for three. You got it. Two. Now hold low, drop the hips even lower. Bring that heel high and start to pulse it. Eight, we got it. Seven, six, five, four, three. Put the heel down. We're rotation again. It's out, in, but we're staying in that left glute like you read about, right? You feeling that? Out, in. Three more for three. You got it. Two. Now on one, take your weight to the floor, reset your shoulders. Ready? Give me a little. Row it up. There you go. Seven more. Oh, I feel that left glute for you, right? How we doing? Let's go. Five more. We got it. Who's coming in here? We got somebody else. There, this is Alyssa, and we got Melissa. Alyssa and Melissa. Hold right here and pulse it. Down. Five, four, three, two, one. Now rotate to your left, right arm forward. Hinge your body. Kick it back in. Now notice this. She has got that left elbow nice and high. This is tricep work, working through the back of this arm right there. So bring that left elbow super high. Keep the shoulders down. Feeling some love in the legs as well. Let's go three more for three, two, Now one, pull it right here and start to pulse down an inch. Let's go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Now one more kick back. There it is. Kick it back. Here's your option. You can always come to standing in a skier squat instead. Let's go. 5 more. There it is. 4. You can always drop to lower weight as well. We are just challenging these muscles to their edge. 2 more for 2. Unwind. Great work. Put your weight down. You're going back into a plank position. We will start this time with your hands and knees in a tabletop position. Give me a cat-cow, if you will. Give it a nice cat stretch all the way up, all the way down. Let's get that spine nice and loose, nice and strong. One more time. Now, find your neutral spine. Now, walk your feet back into that plank position. I always want you to tap your knees, press back. Tap the knees, press back. Notice how she's keeping her hips right in that same level. We're not moving the hips around. We're just challenging that plank. You got 4 more for 4. Here we go. For 3, looking so good today, you guys. I know how strong you are. Look at you go. Hold. Hands go wide. 10 push-ups now. We're going to bend. Extend. Drop to your knees if you need it. There is nothing wrong with that. You're just keeping it strong, keeping it in alignment. Let's go 6 more. 6. Here it is. Breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth. For 5, you are killing it. We got 3 more. Let's go for 3. Good. 2. You got a 1 minute hold right here, a 1 minute hold. Now, when you're holding here, I want you to start to pay attention to everything that's happening. Notice where you're feeling any tightness, any pain in joints. You're gonna really, especially shoulders, pull the shoulders down the back. Biggest key I can give you is keep the belly button pressed through your spine. Keep that core on and strong right here. Inner thighs are going to squeeze together, which is going to help connect into that transverse abdominis. If you need to drop to your knees or pike your hips up during this minute hold, you can do that, but push it right to your edge before you do it and then come right back to it. So you're still going to get this benefit. Not still going to get this benefit. You're going to get a massive benefit from this. If you got a minute in your day, this is what you do for your workout. So hold right here. You've got about 10 seconds. Look at that go. Time going for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give me a shell stretch. Just take a deep breath in through your nose. Nice, Melissa. All the way back up. Okay, you ready to do the other side? So we're going to grab your heavy weight. Whatever it is, if you've got an 8, 10, 5, whatever is heavy for you, I respect your body. I want you to, too. And I believe we're on the right arm working, right, Lee? Yeah, so bring that left arm high, drop it low, and let's give me a bend. Extend. Full range. There you go. So I want you to concentrate on that bicep curl. Full bicep curl, full extension. Yes, that is key. If you start to feel any pain, anything in your elbow, you can always turn your palm toward your body for a hammer curl instead. That'll take it out. You got 2 more. For 2, 1. Hold right here. It's high heel, low heel. So you're super low. You're ready for this now. You did the other side. Those legs are nice and toasty up warm. Let's go. 4 more. 3. You got it. 2. Now start to pulse it down an inch. Pulse. Looks so good. Here it is. Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2. Now put your heels down. Here's your move. We're going out, in. Rotator cuff love right there. Yeah, you want to feel the biceps stay connected. You want to feel that shoulder open up for 4. There it is. 3. Let's do it. 2. Now stay low right here and give me a bend, extend. Now as you extend, I want you to extend those legs all the way up. Bend and extend. So she's in a hammer curl. Yes, palms are toward your screen. You got 4 more for 4. Let's do it for 3, 2. Now hold right here. Just sweep it forward. Remember this one? We're going down inch, up an inch. Option is a hammer curl instead. Looks like that. For 2, and 1. Now bring that palm to the sky and give me that down and up. Little lower and lift. Yes, hold onto your chair or to your whatever stable in your space you're working out in. If you've got more advancement, you can always take that arm in the air. 2 more. For 2, on 1. Now hold what you got. Just bring those heels together, toes apart, and go down. 1, 2, 3. Same thing. We're going to go down inch, up an inch. Yes, there you go. Nothing like working with these chairs. That's going to keep you low. I would rather see you holding onto a surface than trying to do the flare and not getting quite as low. Let's go four more for four, three. We got it. For two, hold right here. Start to pulse it down, down, as low as you can go. Yeah, maybe that arm comes up. Now, let's go for four, three, two. Ready? Let's take it out, in. Breathe through it. Yeah, one more time. Hold. Now, we're going to combine that move. Looks like this. Bend halfway, and then out. There you go. Halfway curl, and then out. Good work. Yeah, you got your water. Good. Bend halfway, and it's out. Two more times. Let's go. Inhale and exhale. Last one. Woo, feels good. Exhale. Now hold what you got. Drop two more floors. Oh, 10 curls right here. 10. You got it. 9. You're feeling that right bicep just like you did on the left. Maybe those legs are burning up and you take that break with Lee. We've got three more for three. Everybody's arms come up and pulse down an inch. Let's go. Final 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, on one. Take a moment. Bring your shoulders up. Bring that arm here. Other arm above your head. Rest. Yes. Press. So pay attention. One shoulder might be a little trickier than the other one. Make sure you can see that weight in your peripheral vision above your head. Yes, we are not pushing through any joint pain here. You make the motion without a weight if you need to. Two more for two. On one, hold right here. We're going in nice and slow, out nice and slow. This is slow motion for this anterior deltoid muscle, that pretty little cut in your shoulder. That's why you got it. Let's go two more. In for two, out. Last one, in, hold, palm the face. Extend. Five more for five. We got this. For four, you guys look so good. For three, almost there. For two, on one, sweep it out, get low, overhead 8 times. 8, there it is. So you're low in those legs. Keep the core engaged. There it comes. Let's go. Just a reach down. Final three. We've got it. Nice, Alyssa, for two. On one, great work. Shake it out a little bit. Okay, so we're going to bend into that right knee, left hand behind the back. Give me a row. Now I want that weight to start at the floor. So the hips are much lower than the shoulders. So we don't even want to round this. We want a nice flat position here at the back. Belly nice and deep. Let's go for six. You guys look good. For five, how we doing? For four, let's do it. For three, two, now one. Start to pulse it down an inch, nice and low. Maybe that right heel comes high because you were that strong today. Let's go three more for three, two, heel is down. Let's go. Open, close. Oh, we have to remember this list. I like it. Out and in. Out. Let's go four more times for four. You got it. Three, two. Good. That weight is on the floor. You ready? Reset the shoulders. Let's give me a open, close. Just bring that elbow high. Woo! Feels good. Let's go. Five more for four. Looking good, you guys. Three. Here it comes. For two, we're gonna pulse it out right here. Start to pulse down an inch. For six, turning in five, four, three, two. She's gonna turn her right. Left arm is extended. Right arm is giving me a little tricep work. You could always come to ski or squat instead of that lunge. I want that tricep working right here. Back of your arm feels so good. Getting a little bicep stretch as well. That is your beauty right there. Four more for four. You got it. For three, looking good. Two, unwind, elbow by the side. Press, press. Let's go. Six, five, four. Last set with the triceps. Here we go. Kick it back. Bend. Maybe you come up into that ski or squat. Whatever you do, you listen to your body and you push hard into that tricep. You got four more. Four. Here it is. For three, going straight back into plank. In two and one. Put that heavy weight down. Let's push back into a plank. We're going to start on your elbows, though. That's good stuff. Starting on the elbows. And as you do that, I want you to drop your knees to the floor one more time. Reset shoulders down the back. When I say reset, pull the shoulders like I'm behind you, pulling them down. Now curl your toes under. Don't move your hips, just straighten your legs. there's your perfect plank. If your leave your knees on the ground, you leave them there. But we're gonna hip dip. We wanna work that waist. You ready? She's ready, she's going. We're going left and right. Oh yeah. But you got a good music list, it makes you happy, right? Let's go, right to left. Four more for four, three, two, one. Bring that right leg high, lift it up eight times. Eight, seven, six, five. We're gonna try to leave it up and go into a side plank. Woo, right now in two and one. Left elbow down, try to bring that right leg and right arm high. Oh wow, how's that going? Show them what else they can do. Yeah, there's your other option, hold. You got five, four, three, two. Reach everything in long and lean and crunch it in and out. Four more for four. Yeah, three, you got it. Two, and one, come back through center and keep those hips low. You're in that elbow plank, you ready? Same thing, hip dips, right and left. Let's go, right, left. Feels so good. Looks good too. Here it is. This is whittling your waist down, keeping that core nice and strong. Four, three, two, one. We are simply going on that other side plank. Oh no, we're lifting that leg up. Yes, let's go. Six more for five. Then we're going to the side plank in three, two, and one. Elbow down, left elbow down. Now lift that leg up. If you need a modification, follow me right there. Hold five, four, three, two, one, crunch it in. It's five. Yes, if you got the leg up, you're crunching that leg in for two. On one, come back through center and hold 10 seconds before we come up to straight arms. Now, I'm gonna challenge you to stay in this plank as we come up. We're gonna separate our feet in three, two, one. Separate your feet slightly. We're going right hand, left hand, right elbow, right and left, right? Left, so it's opposite. These are called up downs, very technical term for this one. Elbow, elbow, one more time. Guess what? Bring those inner thighs together. Are you ready? You got 10 push-ups, basic stuff, ready? Let's do this thing, let's hit it. Bend, extend, eight more for eight. You guys look great, breathe through it. We got six more for six. Here you go, Melissa, for five, looking good. For four, three, pike those hips all the way up on one. Pike them up. You need that break. No, yeah, you're going to keep those abs nice and deep. You're going to walk the heels down. Let's go for four, three, two, one. Now come back into your plank position. You have got a 90-second hold. Did I say 90? Yes, I did. So that means I got to look at my clock. So what I want you to do right here for 90 seconds is to hold stillness. This is called straight through stillness. This is called core work at its best. You're in perfect alignment. Your head is in line with your back. Everything is in line. Pull the belly button deeper into the spine. Now, if you feel any pain at all in that low back, tuck your tailbone under, possibly come to your knees. But if not, I want a nice neutral spine. Just hold right here. We have got, right now, starting here, 60 seconds on this clock. You're holding this. This is non-movement. This is isometric, full body work right here. Heart rate's up, everything's engaged, all muscles are engaged to keep you winning this battle with gravity, and I am looking at your clock, and you are down to 40 seconds. Life is good. You are pushing through. You are hanging with me, Alyssa, and Melissa, and everybody hanging with me. Let's count it down, 25 seconds. Eyes are on the clock. Belly is in, head is high. You have got this. You have got this. This is where you make that change. Hang with me. 15 seconds. This is it. You ready? Let's count it. Almost there. Let's count now for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shell stretch it back. Great work. Okay, as you shell stretch it back, I want you to take your right arm, weave it through, and keep that left hand where it is. You're going to get a great shoulder stretch here. So she's showing you how that looks. Keep the belly button in, core stays connected. Now reach up with the other hand, reach away, and then weave that one through. Keep your nose onto your on your mat so you're feeling a nice left shoulder stretch. Now curl your toes under, and let's sit up on your knees. How are your knees today? Maybe you need to come up high with Lee right there, or you can sit back on those toes that are bent. And let's bring that right elbow up. Give it a little side bend, maybe look up at the sky, deep breath in. As you exhale, let's go the other way, a little tricep stretch right here. So let's open the pecs up, give me presses. Back, back, for three, two. Now reach behind your back. Grab your hands together. Open the chest up. Lift them as high as you can. And look to the left. And then look to the right. And then release them. Upper back stretch right here. And then shoulders up and down. Okay, so I want you to pick up 3-pound weights. Your option is also to use no weights at all. Remember that? So we're going to use lighter weights. We're going to stay in the legs. And of course, we're going to stay in the shoulders and upper body as well. We have found that these combo moves are going to get your results a little bit faster and definitely safer. Heels together, toes apart. Take your weights to your chest. Bring your heels about that far off the floor. Let's go down on four. Down one, two, three, four. Bring your arms back in field goal the way you had it before. Now drop one more floor. Give me a little pelvic tilt. As you do, you're lifting those arms up. Let's go. Five, four, three, two. Now take the pelvic tilt out. Keep a neutral spine. Drop one more floor. Your move is reach, reach. Good. Interesting beat. Six, five, four. She should be Mike. Three. We got it. Two. Hold right here. Keep that left arm right where it is. Just right arm only. Yes. Drop it low in those legs. Yes. One more time. Hold. Reset the shoulders. Other arm is press. Press. Good. Let's go for three, two, on one. Now, all I want you to do is bring those weights above your head. Make a little halo. Guess where you're going to the floor on four. Let's go down one, two, three, four. As if you were against a wall. You're not hinging forward. No. You're in alignment. You're not going past any knee pain because you are listening to your body very clearly. Here it is. Let's go down. One, two, three, four. You got one more trip. And when you do, you're going to buy that condo down on the floor because you're going to stay there. Get it low. Now pulse it. Down an inch. Down an inch. There you go. Let's go. Four, six, five, four, three. Hold. Drop it low and hold. Five, four, three, two, one. Shake it out. Reset the shoulders. Take your feet out wide, back in that wide second position. Same thing, overhead, except it's different, right? We're in that wide second position. Get those inner thighs stretched out. Taking it low, working those legs, press. Keeping the core on. Keeping the breath coming, nice and even. In through the nose, out through the mouth. Three more for three, two. Now on one, hold right here. High heel, low heel, high heel, low heel. Yeah, there it is. Let's go. Five, four, three, two. Keep that left heel high. Let's give it a little TikTok. Now, if that's not for you, maybe you got a little low back issue today. You're just right here. Two more. Now on one, pick up a halo again with those weights. Bring that heel even higher to the side. Pulse it down. Four, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Follow me. She's just going to rotate to her left. Bring your elbows in. Hold right here. Pull the belly button in. Give me a little reach. Squeeze. Now, we're going to make this a little tougher in three, two. Now, hold right here. We call this direct traffic. Extend. Extend. You are welcome to go back to that first move that we were doing. It is too much on your shoulders. We're pushing hard on shoulders today. Let's go for three, two, on one, take your palms to the floor, squeeze that back. Squeeze the back. Give me a little bend of that back leg as you do it. There you go. Let's go five. Five. Here it goes. How are we doing, Brittany? We got it. For three. For two. Pulse down an inch. Drop it low. For five. Four. Three. Two. On one, step it all the way up. Give me a little shoulder roll all the way up. Shake everything out. Shoulder roll, leg roll, everything. Heels together, toes apart, weights to your chest. Let's do it again. Let's go. Really nice and low. We're going one, two, three, four. Palms are here. Reset. Give me moves. Above your head and down. Above your head. There it is. Breathe through it. Feels so good. Let's go. Six more. Here it is. For five. Nice work, you guys. Four, three, two. Hold right here. Pulse it. Eight, seven, six, five. This is my favorite part because we get to go nice and low. Take those weights back to your chest. Ready? Down on four. Down one, two, three, four. Coming back. Two. And again, it is as if you were against a wall. There is no hinging forward. This is keeping that Pilates posture, keeping it strong. We're going down, two, three, four. We're bringing it up. One more time, low as you can go. We're going down, two, stay right here. Take those weights above your head. Drop one more floor, press those thighs. Back, back, four, six, five, four, three. Final 10 pulses, down an inch. You've got this, almost there. Breathe through it. We got seven more for seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Waste your chest. Reset the shoulders. Take your feet out wide. Same thing. Let's go. Reach down. Yeah, if you need to take that break, you can always take those weights to your side. There it is for four. Four, three. Here we go. Two. Hold right here. High heel, low heel. High, low, high, low. Feels so good. Let's go four more. Four, three. Tick-tock to your right, to the right. Yeah, how's that back feel? If you need to come up and down, you do that. Four, three, here we go. Two, and one, just pulse it. Pulse, pulse. For three, two, now find that halo and lean to your right, and let's go. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, on one. You ready to rotate? Oh yeah, let's start that reach and squeeze first. It's reach, squeeze. That's your go-to when you push too hard in those shoulders. For two, now on one, let's direct a little traffic. Bend, extend, there you go. Keeping the shoulders down, the ears working hard, heart rate's up. Three more, for three, there it is. Two, keeping that knee bending. On one, palm to the floor, squeeze back. Yeah, so I want you to just squeeze the muscles in your around your spine. Feels so good. Squeeze it back. Get low in that leg because you're gonna feel that glute and ham working strong over time. Let's go two more for two. Hold right here and pulse it down an inch, down an inch. Let's go four, three, two, one. Stand it up. You're gonna grab your heavy weights again. Your 5 or 8 pound weights, whatever you got, 5, 6, 7, 8s. Palms are forward. I just want you to give me a little sit in your chair. Sit down, down. Now as you do it, you're pressing the tailbone to the back of your room. So you're not hinging, you're not rounding forward. You're keeping that back flat, down and up. Four more for four, three, here we go, two. Now drop it low, toes are light, pulse it down for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Put your weights on the floor. Take your right leg in the air. We've got a kundalini stretch. Yeah, looks good. Let's go and bend the knee down and then all the way up. You want to hit that beat? There it is. Let's go. Eight. Nice. So I want you to really extend that leg to your ceiling, feeling that standing leg go like crazy. For two, and one, step your feet all the way back for a plank, for a 30-second plank right here. Now, as you press it back, your hands stay on those weights. If that's too much for your wrist, I mean, for your hands, sometimes you can come off. But right now, you got a 20-second hold. This is where you reset the body. This is where you feel and see your strength. Nice work, Melissa. Nice work, Alyssa. Can't see you, but I know you're doing it. You got about halfway through, so head is down. Yes, there it is. Keep it nice and strong. We got 10 seconds. Hold strong right here. Let's count it for 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Just step those feet forward. Take that left foot down, right leg in the air. Yeah, sorry, I couldn't remember which side. No, we're not. We're doing another kundalini. Sorry, miscommunication in the room. All right, left leg up, left leg up. So we're just going straight back into that kundalini. We're gonna bend for two, all the way. Here we go, let's go, bend. Full extension, bend, full extension. Yes, here we go. Four more, feels good. For three, two, and one. Lift it up and hold. Five, four, three, two, one. Step it back into a plank. Take your hands off of your weights. Take them wide. You got 10 push-ups right here. Here it is. Let's get a bend, extend, eight more, eight. Looks so good, you guys. Six, we've got it. Nice movement, nice strong work. This is a moving plank. Three more for three, two, on one. Now we get a shell stretch because you guys deserve a shell stretch. Deep breath in. Keep your heavy weights. We're gonna take it to your back on the ground. heavyweights today. Now, you know, when I say heavyweight, that means you can go lighter. If you need to go to 3 pounds, do it. But I want you to, every single time you do this workout, try to build up that resistance. So we're going to go heavyweights here, meaning 8 pounds, right? 8, 6, 5s, whatever you got. Low back is down. Now, put your heavyweights to your hip flexors right here. Now, tuck your tailbone under. So the low back is pressed down, pelvic tilt. We're going to roll the low back off the ground on two. We're rolling up for two, rolling down for two. Now lift your toes so you start to feel a little bit more work in those hamstrings. Not to mention the glutes, right? One more time. Roll it all the way up. Hold right here. Pull the belly button in and pelvic tilt. Tilt. So the more you lift those toes, the more you're going to feel those hands start to work. Now, if those weights are too much, put your hands down on the floor. You got six more. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Put your weights above your chest. Now reach them all the way out to a fly. Here's your move. Roll it up, down. Notice her hips are coming up. We're combining the chest work with the glute and ham. Up, down. Yes, there you go. It's full range with arms, with glutes and hands. Let's go for two on one. Now hold everything upright here. I want you to take those arms behind your ears as you drop the hips down and then bring them all the way back up on the feet. Let's go. Up for two, down for two, or on that two beat. There it is, and down. One more time, all the way up, all the way down. Now keep your arms where they are, just bring your hips up. Tuck it under, hold, pulse it up five times. 5, 4, 3, 2, on one, take your hands down to the floor, reset the body. Put your left heel, dig it into the floor. Straighten your right leg to the ceiling, all right? Now roll the hips up as high as you can go. Bring your arms out wide. This is a lot of core work. This is a lot of hamstring work, a lot of glute. She's starting to move. We're going up, down, full range. Notice her right leg is in the air and it is not moving much. This is going up and down. The hips are moving. Hips up in the air. Lift, lower, chest work. There it is. 4, 4. We got it for two. Now on one, bring those arms out inside. Deeper pelvic tilt, pulse it up for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Now on one, bring your weights above your chest, but turn your palms toward your thighs. Bring it into field goal, following me right here in full range. We're going reach. There it is. It's reach. Yes, as you do it, you're gonna feel a lot of work in that chest, in that glute. It's an interesting song. For five. For four, no hard time getting the beat. For three, two, now hold right here. Bring those arms by the side, pulse it out for 8, 8, 7, 6, got it. 5, 4, 3, 2, on one, hands go down to the floor. For heaven's sakes, give those knees into your chest, give it a rock side to side. Yeah, taking a little stretch. I want you to take that left hand to that back of that left leg. Extend that left leg into the sky. Let's give it a small stretch before we go to the other leg. Deep breath in, deep breath out. All right, you ready to do it again? We got to work in to that right hamstring. So grab your heavy weights, put them on your hip flexors. Roll it up for two, taking it low for two. We're rolling it up, two, low. How we doing? You're looking good, Melissa. Let's do this thing down. For two. Oh, we've got Loretta in here. I didn't even see you, Loretta. Of course, that's okay. We're rolling up. Nice work. Down. Last one. Now tuck and hold right here. Arms go wide. Up and over. Going up and down. Seven more. Let's do it. You feel that chest work? You feel those hands and glutes? You feel how strong you are? You got four more. For four. Let's do it. For three. Two. Unwind. Now hold those arms and pulse it up an inch. Yeah, both feet are down, but you know we're going in to that right leg. Is that right? In three, two, one. Put your weights down first. Take that right heel, dig it into your mat, shoot that left leg straight up, bring those arms out wide. Same thing. Let's go. Lift, lower. Ah, looks so good, you guys. You're killing it. Let's go, Alyssa. Bring it on. Here it is. Let's go. Five more. Nice work for four. You guys have got this for three. Let's do it for two. On one. Yes. Now hold right here. Pulse it. Eight, seven. Got it. Six, five, four, three. Everything comes up. Now put your palms forward. Bring those elbows down to the little field goal and all the way up, all the way down. It is a ton of work on this hamstring. Right hamstring, white glute, chest work. Let's go, core work. Three more. For three, you got this. For two, on one, start to pulse it. Up for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. On one, both feet down. Before we stretch it out, put those hip weights on your hip flexors. Roll it up one more time. Now bring those weights right above your head and take everything down and everything back up. One more time, all the way down, all the way up. This time, all the way down, now hold. Bring those inner thighs together, bring your hips up in the air. Pulse it up for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, on one, everything is down. Take that right leg into the air, little hamstring stretch right here. After you take your little side to side, little rock for that low back. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Great work. All right, so we're going to leave that leg in the air because we're going to go into some ab work. We've got your right leg up. I want you to nod your chin and walk your hands up that leg all the way to the calf if you can. Now, here's your goal. Yes, following lead, maybe putting your foot on the floor, more advanced hovering. Now, your goal is to have those shoulder blades off and start to curl it up an inch, up an inch. Now, here's a goal to also reach. I want you to reach that left arm. Maybe try to touch that toe. Reach, reach. You've got six, five, four, three, two. Sweep it over to that right leg and cross it. Give me an up, up, over. You're trying to stack your left shoulder on top of your right. Meanwhile, your right shoulder blade is off the floor. There it is. One, two, three. Let's go. Four more. For three, you got it. For two, now we're gonna hold right here, fist bump eight times. For eight, seven, maybe you just hold on today because that is where you can feel that work in that waist. For two, on one, put your hands on the ground. Take your let both legs in the air, hold. Here's your move. You're gonna lift up, hold, and then bring it back down. It's a lift up, hold. Now notice she's not going very far, right? It's just engaging through that transverse abdominis. It's just getting nice and strong, flat tummy, strong back. Now start to pulse it up an inch, up an inch. Oh, life is good, you're doing it. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, on one, other leg drops. Now your right leg is gonna hover or it's gonna bend and put your foot on the floor. Nod your chin, walk your hands up to that calf. Elbows are wide, we're curling up. Up, just like that. Feels so good. Oh, here she's already got that left arm off. You're reaching for that right toe. Five more for five, four, three, two, and one. Let's just reach it all the way up and over. Three counts. Let's go up, up, and over. That right shoulder is trying to go right on top of the left. Let's go. It's up, up, hold. For three, two, now one. Fist bumps again. Let's go. Bump. You've got eight, seven, good work. Six, five, four, three, two. Now on one, head and shoulders down. Lift your legs up. Now how are your hips today? Maybe you need a little bend in these knees, but I want to see those hips come off the ground. Let's do it. Nice and high. Going up, hold, and then down you go. Lift it up. Stay. That's not easy stuff, right? Connecting deeply through that transverse abdominis. Nice deep belly muscle. Lifting up. Now start to pulse it up an inch or more than an inch, just as high as it'll go. Now you're not gonna get a lot, but what you wanna avoid is rocking those toes to your face for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, on one. Turn your knees to your right, keep those legs straight and give me little pulses up, 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 up. Let's go, five, four, three, two, on one, come back through center and let's just go the other way. Keep the knees a little bit bent. Let's go for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, come back through center one more time. Punch it up 10 times, up 10, nine, we're almost there. We get to stretch it out in seven, 6. I brought good stuff today. Okay, we're going to do a figure four today. So put your left foot on the floor, take your right leg, cross it over, and then nod your chin, reach up for the left thigh, and push with your right elbow on that inner thigh, and feel that nice deep stretch in your glute, your right glute. And then head and shoulders go back to the floor. And let's release and change legs. So we're going to take that opposite leg up and put your hand on that right thigh. Give yourself a nice stretch right here. Deep breath in through your nose, out through your mouth. Great work. All right, so we're going to sit all the way up. We're going to sit nice and tall. You're going to bend your right knee in half, extend your left leg all the way out. Your goal is to try to get that outer thigh to the floor. So as you do that, try to reach for that left toe. If you have a towel or a strap, you can use that to touch that toe. As you bring that arm up, I want you to look up under the arm and then rotate all the way down to that left thigh, feeling that nice deep stretch through the hamstring, but especially through that right side of your waist and low back. Great low back stretch. And then slowly bring it up, and let's just change legs. Extend your right leg. Bend your left knee in half. Your outer thigh on your left leg is trying to touch the ground. And then you're going to reach for those right toes. Bring that left arm all the way up. Big side bend, looking up under that arm. And then rotation of the chest down toward the floor. Take a deep breath in through your nose. You guys work so hard every single time we do this. Very impressed every time. So bring yourself up to sitting. So you're going to crisscross your legs. And you're going to close your eyes for a second. Fingers will go to your belly, thumbs to your rib cage. I want you to close nice and tight. Bring your shoulders up to your ears. Roll them down. Now let's take the deepest breath of your day. Inhale through your nose. Filling the lungs up with air. And then exhale. Blow it out through your mouth. And feel that belly button press to your spine. And everything zip up nice in a tight core connection. Once again, deep breath in through your nose. As you exhale, blow everything out. Keep that core connection. Take that left fingertips out to the side, right fingertips to the left side of the head. Keep the eyes closed as you give yourself a gentle neck stretch, looking toward that right thigh now with a small turn toward the right thigh and a gentle tug, little trap stretch here, a little posterior neck release with your breath. And then all the way up, let's take the left fingertips to the right side of your head. Right fingertips travel away. Deep breath in through your nose. As you exhale, rotate your face down to that thigh. And come all the way back up. Once again, close your eyes. Bring your shoulders high, back, and down. Open your eyes. Great work, Biko. You guys did a great job today. It's always good to see you, and I look forward to seeing you next week.